Scheduling is really where the primary identification comes from delays. It's the main communication tool in the project, but it's also the basis for delay. And if the schedules are terrible, then delay analysis is going to be terrible. So we use the schedules to identify delay and to do the analysis. When the actual delays have happened, we use forensic analysis to go back in and examine it and find out what happened. We start with the premise that a well-maintained schedule will show the effects of delay. So if you keep that under your belt all the time, if we do a good job with the schedule, it'll show the effects of delay. Whether you're not, whether you add activities in there for delays or not, it's going to show the effects of delay. But it, you know, and to make sure we can identify delays and do something with them, I believe it requires first a risk-based contingency determination for cost and time. So every project should have contingency. It should be risk-based. In other words, it should be not just a percentage, but it should be identified based on a risk register of risks. And then, you know, we can carry that in costs. The industry is usually not, doesn't have a strong appetite for carrying time contingency, but we can carry it in a management reserve, or we can go into the schedule and make sure there's adequate time so that the contingency becomes kind of risk avoidance to make sure that we've covered the things we need to cover in the time. It requires a technical scheduling effort, and that means good clean schedules. That means good technical schedule review, and that's the driver for good construction management. And then the robust project controls effort that allows us to step into claims avoidance, which is where we want to be.